Wrapped extremely well. That was actually on the base, protecting the tower. Really good for the duty. I ordered it 3 days ago. Excellent time. And I think it was, what had a price on it? $41 delivered, I think. Something like that. Yeah, so I'll check it against the old one and make sure it's the right length. Just check the length from here when it's fitted, the snout, to where it bolts on. Sometimes those different ones could be a little bit longer, so just bear that in mind. Right, a bit of an update compared to maybe where I was last time. What have we got done? So, engine's probably halfway finished, put back together. I've painted the block and different parts, different colours, so any oil leaks that show up, I can spot them. The blue I've just done as like water, anything to do with water basically, except this line here, I might have to change that one, that's the oil. Yep, sump's on, pistons are in, new rings, new bearings. Rear main seals back there, it's done. I've replaced everything new where possible. What else are we up to? Alternator's on there just temporarily. About to put the head on, just want to come around. So new water pump, thermostat. I've got to get a new thermostat housing. I've pulled that down, cleaned it all. It all looked pretty good, but yeah, there was rust inside. A new front seal, crank bearings, of course, the bottom end. Got one of our pulleys, that's the AC bracket. I've got that on, the AC pump, aircon pump's on. I've got to buy a new power steering pump. I thought it was okay, but inside was shot. I've got vacuum pump here. I've got to connect that up, of course. I thought I'd paint the fuel pump or injector pump gold because that's what it runs on, gold, diesel. So what else we got? I think that's pretty much it for here. So, I'm just hoping I've pump that might need a rebuild, I don't know, but I've cleaned what I can pretty much in and out, greased what I could, checked bearings, there's no play, no seized parts. What else? I think. So here's the thermostat, rest of the thermostat housing, new rubber pipes. This was actually off a VT Holden Commodore, cut down $30 compared to $70 for two near genuine Pajeros. Happy about that. Clean those pipes out inside as well, rust. Manifold, that was done in an acid type bath, get rid of the rust. Engine mounts are ready. Got the old head bolts I'm gonna use, because what I'm gonna do is, here I've got a new cylinder head. I've got two gaskets, I think I bought a lot of extra parts, gaskets. So I'm actually gonna put the head on. the new head on and assemble it, get it running. Hopefully that's the plan, get it running and then put it in the vehicle. So I'll have a spare head gasket, and I've got in the box here, I've got new head bolts. So that's the plan. So I don't know what's in the box because I haven't opened it yet. So let's set this up. And have a look. So we've got a head gasket, and I've marked here this weighs up in front, and you can tell by the timing cover. Your timing chain comes up through here, well that sits over it. You gotta work that out. As I may have mentioned previously, when I bought the vehicle, the head was off. Apparently just needed a new head gasket, but the head was cracked in four places, blah blah blah, so that's why I decided to full rebuild. Don't trust the rest of it. That's good. Manifold studs for the head, new ones. Yeah, so this off eBay was what was it? Say $900, $950 to get it reconditioned. The old one was $1,600. So this is all brand new. Cam, bearings, brand new. So that's why it was rocking. So, some oil, it's all oiled up. Very nice. It's just stock standard too. Nothing extra special. So brand new, should work better than 340 Ks on the dash. So I'll put a head gasket on, I suppose, and go from there. Surface has been all cleaned off. Just done that again. I've had it all covered up, but cleaned off. Timing chain's just got a paper tie around that. So spray any copper solution, spray anything extra, they don't recommend it. So, put the dowel here and a dowel there. Hopefully you can see that. Just checking it's the right size, all the holes line up. Reassessing to do.
You gotta push this forward to allow for the shaft.
Cube shaft. And the cube shaft's gotta light that hole. Let's bring it over and have a go. Okay, I'll be back.
All tightened up. So that's done, that's all secure. Oil to go in and the filter. I'm gonna prime the filter, some oil, get this cap off. I'm gonna do it, and of course. And I've got the date written all over this thing, 0 kilometers, 0 hours, of course. Good. And I think it's up tight. And then we'll go a quarter of a turn. Doesn't even need to do that, but try it there, that's snug. Then now I've got it left. Okay, so 6 liters. So what I'm going to do, basically just put it everywhere, I suppose you could say. Probably doing it wrong, but you never know. Don't really care. I can't see it. It's got to come up to the top, go back down. So, but yeah, leave a comment. Tell me if I'm right or wrong. So, if I am wrong, someone else might learn from my mistakes. I'm going to leave about a litre the route, so that'll be six in total. Stand for a while and see how we go. It does recommend 7 odd litres total, so I'll put 6 in for now. I've got to repaint this wafer cover, tapper cover. It's all been nice and clean. I've got a new gasket to go on. I'm going to set that there, keep everything out for now. Oil back up. Keep it all nice and clean. Spend hours and hours and hours cleaning, so contaminants. Not worth cleaning if you don't look after it later. Alright, so that's it for now.